Whooping cough outbreak at a Milwaukee school is now spreading.
WISN 12 News has learned absences are increasing despite an extensive cleaning effort launched by the school last week. 12 News reporter Nick Bohr is live at St. Matthias on Milwaukee's south side. Nick?
And Toya, we just called the health department and they verified for us the rising number of cases here at St. Matthias on the southwest side, as you mentioned. This serves students from K-4 through 8th grade. And last Thursday, parents were told the health department had verified whooping cough was spreading through the vaccinated children here. At the time, they learned there were 17 cases of pertussis or whooping cough in students. Today, they learned that number has grown to 28 confirmed cases. That news comes despite the school's efforts to clean and sanitize the desks and other surfaces the students come into contact with. And parents are being reminded of the importance of vaccinations, which include boosters for the pertussis at 4 years old and again at 11 years old prior to sixth grade. Parents here tell us the school is doing a good job of keeping them informed and they're watching their children closely for symptoms.
Any type of illness is a concern, but as long as the kids are vaccinated and the school has been great taking all the precautions, you know, and we put trust in the school and until we have further information.
Yeah.
I should mention it's not clear if the students who have this have been vaccinated or not. That's something they're still working on. The principal tells us most, if not all, of the new cases, though, are coming in as a result of some testing that was done late last week and early this week. In light of those new cases, the school, though, has decided to cancel their Grandparents' Day, which was scheduled for this Friday. The health department tells us that besides the 28 cases here, there are only two other cases in the area, both of them at MPS schools, both of them at different schools. Live here at St. Matthias on the southwest side, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.